Greetings, YouTubers. Here is the guy with the Swiss accent. Happy New Year to all of you. Because this video will go live at 6 a.m. Middle European time, for some of you it might still be before midnight. If so, just close the screen and open it tomorrow again. For the rest, I prepared a short video with the usual three topics. Look back, look at where we are today, and a forecast into the next year. Some of you might miss the goals for the next year. Because I'm a hobby YouTuber, I go with Confucius, who said, "The way is the goal." And frequent viewers know that I enjoy this way a lot. Maybe I'm able to share or transfer this enthusiasm to one or the other, especially to young people. Electronics, and especially shortwave radio, was my hobby when I was young. And this hobby later on made it possible for me to have a family and raise my kids. And it makes it possible to enjoy life even if I turn 60 this year. But enough about past times. What happened last year? Thanks to YouTube, I have quite a good overview about that. Let's first concentrate on the channel itself. First, on the currency of YouTube, the subscribers. The channel hit the 1,000 subscribers on February 5th, nearly a birthday gift. At this time, about 20 people subscribed per day. This number went up quite fast, also because I was once featured by Hackaday.io. In May, June, I was abroad on a big project for many weeks. This can be seen also in the numbers of subscribers gained during this time. After that, the growth of the subscribers was quite steady and reaches now about 60 per day. And yesterday, the channel crossed the 14,000 subscribers mark, with viewers from 144 countries. This is the real power of the internet. Here are the top countries. And here the ones with the least views. Let's focus a moment on the top 10 videos of last year. One focused on batteries, another one on GPS modules, a third one on the new A6 GSM module. Then I had two next-gen display tutorials in the top 10. The Maker 1000 video was not a nice one, but because of its honesty, it is placed as number 3. The rest of the videos are ESP8266 videos. Now to the undiscovered gems, the videos with the least views. This is the video about my Swiss Army knife. It has now its regular appearance in the mailbags. The videos about 3D printing were not important to you, even if I thought I could share some knowledge there. One small remark. The concept of the automatic switch-off made its revival in one of my more successful videos, the Amazon Dash. If you do not believe it, check it. My first 4 videos published on YouTube all made it on this losers list. This is particularly sad because the Morse trainer presented here was an innovation which was even purchased by the Swiss military. But I have to admit, this was in the 80s. I still like it because it helped me to pay for my studies then. This is why I ported it to Arduino. As said, subscribers are the currency of YouTube. More important for me, however, is the time you spend with my videos. This number also increased quite constantly and reached 20,000 minutes per day. This means that every day you guys watch my videos for 19 days. This is quite impressive for me, because I well know that you could do many other things with your valuable time. Thank you very much. Another important report is the report about traffic sources. It shows how videos and channels are detected. And here I have to say Thank you again, because a big chunk of the videos, this red part, comes from channel browse, where you basically browse through the videos of the channel and discover some new stuff. The suggested videos here in blue are particularly important for all channels because Google presents new videos also to people which do not know the channel. And this number depends heavily on the famous likes and comments. This is the reason why I ask you for that favor. Here you see that about every 10th viewer also presses the like button. And you see also that I always get some thumbs down. I would really be glad to know in the comments what the reason for these thumbs down was. And here you see the most liked and the most hated videos. The most liked one is obvious. In this video, I asked directly for your support with likes and comments, and you responded. Thank you again. And the most hated one was the rant about at this time unfinished Maker 1000. Some viewers thought that this was unfair to Arduino. Where do we stand today? The channel is now visible on a global basis. But more important for me are the comments. We have a regular exchange and I get a lot of very, very nice comments. You can believe it, this matters to me. And recently I discovered another fact which I enjoy very much. Viewers start to help each other with problems. So sometimes it is even not necessary for me to answer, because a viewer shared directly its experience. Great, we become a community. Just a remark to the comments. As you know, I try to answer every comment, with one exception, if it has absolutely nothing to do with the video. But it might be that I oversee one or the other comment. YouTube is not very good in presenting these comments. Sorry for that. In the meanwhile, it takes me about 1 hour or more per video to answer all of the comments. But I like it and I apologize for the forgotten answers. Recently, I added also Facebook and Twitter. There, I try to share a little more and a little earlier. Where are we heading? Usually, mailbags are a glimpse into the future, because sometimes I have an idea or I see some interesting stuff, or a viewer has a good idea about a new topic. Then I have to get the parts. You might laugh now, but even if I already have a lot of parts, for most of the new projects, I need some more. And when the products arrive, they usually end up in a mailbag, and you know what will follow in the future. In addition, I open now my secret project stack. It has the form of folders on my computer. And to make sure that they are not forgotten, they get an exclamation mark in front of them. If I sort the folder now, they appear all before the other files. After the project is finished, the folder gets the number of the YouTube video. Inside these folders, I start to collect information. If I find, for example, a link, I create a Word document in the respective folder and put this link in. This is my way to organize myself. Simple, but okay for my purpose. And the project boxes you know already from other videos. So, which projects are now in this folder? To make it clear, this is an alphabetical order, not an order in time. And it is well possible that many other projects can appear in between. And sometimes a project idea will also be deleted. So, if we start with the smallest device, I like the AT Tinies, and I would like to do a project with them in the next time. Maybe it could be in conjunction with another interesting device, the VL53LOX. This would give a nice new radar for my self-balancing robot. On the next level, we find things like solar power for small devices and a mobile power supply to be used in hotel rooms and in other locations outside the lab. The comparison of LEO chips fits neatly into this category. If we go to communication, you see LoRa as an important topic, but also a new range test with the ESP8266, maybe when it's a little bit warmer here in Switzerland. Maybe then I even can include an ESP32 into this test. And I would like to concentrate also on other devices in the sub-gigahertz area, which is mainly 433 and 868 megahertz in Europe. Whisper nodes, for example, fit neatly into this topic. Then, of course, you find some ESP8266 topics, and I hope more and more ESP32 topics. On the next level, I would love to start to work a little more with the Raspberry Pi, always in conjunction with the small devices. Topics like Node-RED, Johnny 5, and Firebase fit in this area. So you see, I have stuff for a few months to come. In between, you will see some mailbags, lab reps, and product reviews if interesting new stuff appears. And I am in preparation to organize a raffle where you can win some stuff. Maybe I succeed in making this also a recurring topic in the next year. This could probably increase the suspense a little. Most probably, two things will not change in the near future. The intro into the episode and... I hope this video was useful or at least interesting for you. Maybe I will extend it a little. If true, please like. Bye.